The starting point for urban scaling is similar to the starting point for metabolic scaling. In both, we ask about how properties of something depend on their size. For urban scaling, the size that we'll be interested in is their population, and we'll look at different properties, wages, GDP, length of roads, amount of electricity used, and so on. So in this video, I want to just take an empirical look at this. What does the data suggest about this question? So I'll do so by showing you several plots. And as usual, I'll put the reference for the plots down here. So here's the first one. This is looking at population down here. And this is total wages. And these are for US cities. And in this context, a city is taken to be a metropolitan statistical area. So it might not be exactly the same as a formal city boundary. Often might include suburbs. If you have two cities that are right next to each other, they'll be considered part of the same metropolitan area. So in any event, here's the data. I think we've got around 300 data points here. And this is on a log-log plot. And we can definitely see a linear trend. We can calculate the slope, which we know is the exponent in a power law. That gives us a beta of 1.12. So of note here, this is larger than 1. So what this means is if we have a small city and then we compare that to a city that's twice as large, we might ask, well, how would the wages, the total wages, total amount of money made in both of those cities compare? And you might think, well, the city that has twice as many people should have wages that are twice as much. But what this says is it's actually more than that. It's faster than linear, super linear. So that if you double the population on average, according to this trend, you would more than double the total wages. It would go up by 2 to the 1.12, not 2 to the 1. All right, so so that's sort of interesting, I think, and others have thought, because we might expect that it would be linear. Doubling population would double wages, but that's definitely not what we see. Now, of course, you can't help but notice that there's an awful lot of fuzz around this line. So there's a very clear trend that's pretty hard to deny, but it's not an exact relationship like a physical law might be. There's even more scatter, I think, than for most of the metabolic scaling plots. So there's a lot of variation among cities as well, and there's a clear trend. And as we talked about in metabolic scaling, the trend can be interesting, and the deviations from the trend can be interesting, and those two statements don't need to be in competition with each other. Both can be interesting. And in this case, I think both are interesting. Okay, let's look at a few other results. And there are lots and lots of data sets like this, but I'll just show you a few more. All right, again, we have population on the horizontal axis in a log-log scale. This is log, not of wages, but of GDP, gross domestic product, and these are for Chinese cities. So this is measured in million yuan. And again, we can see there's a very clear trend. It's certainly not a flat line. Beta is 1.12, but for this data set, there's even more variation about that trend. But again, there definitely is a trend line. This plot here is for Germany, German cities. Again, this is a log of GDP, gross domestic product, measured in euros. Very clearly a trend here. Beta in this case is 1.10. And some variation about the trend, but not as much as for China. In both cases, though, this exponent is larger than 1, statistically significantly so, indicating that log of GDP grows faster than linearly with population. So again, in both of these cases, if you double population, you more than double the GDP of a city. All right, let's look at one more of these sorts of plots. So here, this is now the total road miles in a city. How many roads are there measured in miles? And again, this is a log-log plot, population here. And in this case, the exponent is 0.85. So that means the growth is slower than linear. If you double the size of a population, on average, you don't double the length of the roads. It's actually less than double. It's 2 to the 0.85. So let me also explain what these lines are. This line here, the sort of darkest line, is a line with a slope of 1. And what this is showing is that the data themselves are clearly, at their trend is clearly less than 1. These two here, one of these lines is a fit line with that beta. The other is a line from a theory, so a sort of theoretical fit that I'll explain in a subsequent video. So of note, again, here we see a quantity, road miles, that's not scaling linearly, but in this case, the exponent is less than 1. And here's one more GDP plot. This is for US cities. Again, we're seeing faster than linear growth. This black line would indicate linear growth. That's a slope of 1. The measured beta, the measured exponent, is 1.13. So that's faster than linear. And there are actually two lines here. One is the measured exponent, and the other is that predicted by a theory. So there's an urban scaling group at the Santa Fe Institute, led by Louis Betancourt, Jeff West, and many others. They produced a series of papers and are continuing to do so with lots and lots of plots like this. So there are many. There's a lot more data we can look at. But for this video, the main observation is that there's evidence of scaling, some sort of linear relationship on a log-log plot. In some cases, less than linear, in some cases, more than linear. And there's a fair amount of fuzz around this. It's not an exact relationship. It's a trend, but there's still a fair amount of variation around this trend.